Hey everybody, this is Dave Gleason from Athletic Revolution in Pembroke, Massachusetts, and with the IYCA, the International Youth Conditioning Association. So listen, I field a lot of calls and emails with coaches and trainers who are starting in with younger athletes, 6 to 9 years old, and especially 10 to 13 year old kids. Middle school and just under is becoming a very, very popular age group for a lot of coaches. What do we do with these kids, and how do I really maximize the 45 minutes to an hour that we have with them? Now, I was looking over, here's just three of our binders of programming over the last 5 years of our business here, and I thought, you know, it might be really important to share, not necessarily all the ingredients, every single activity that we use, but at least the recipe. And that's what I have right here. It's a templating system. Hopefully you're using this with all of your clientele, but this is a really great way to program and then to eventually teach your staff how to program your classes as well. So when we look at kids 10 to 13 year old, we want to think about first developmentally, what are the things that they need? And then we can kind of plug and play from that aspect, okay? So active range of motion and muscle activation. We start there before we even get into the general prep stuff in a few different ways. We'll actually introduce foam rolling, self-myofascial release with these kids. Just the big ones at least. We'll get their glutes, their T-spines, you're gonna notice they're really starting to tighten up as they go through growth spurts and they sit in school all day and they're kind of hunched over. Video games don't help, obviously. So we'll start to introduce self-myofascial release. Get those quads, hip flexors, glutes, upper back, as I said, the T-spine. We'll also start to get into active range of motion, stretching them through movement. And we'll teach them, guys, this is kind of your flexibility at this age. So they've heard that word before, stretching. So stretching through movement, getting them into a deep squat pattern or a slow mountain climber. Or, you know, really opening up into a prone extension or some thoracic spine rotation. Getting them to move when we know they're getting tight already. And then muscle activation, that's also extremely important. And what we'll say to the kids at this age is, guys, these are muscle groups with really big names that you're probably not going to hear about too much of. So we'll talk about, you know, the muscles along the spine that stabilize the spine. All the muscles in and around the shoulder girdle and the shoulder blades that stabilize that. The muscles that stabilize the hips. You know, what we need to do to move the ankle and get it strong. The stuff that no one else is paying attention to, that's really what we need to do for our kids. So we'll do everything here, like hip lifts, engage those glutes and hamstrings. We'll do prone extensions, again, not just for active range of motion of the T-spine, but to really start to turn on the muscles in their upper back a little bit, because we see muscular immaturity, and as well, we see just general weakness there because they're not pulling, they're not climbing, they're not doing those things on a day-to-day basis. So this is where we start with before we get to general prep or a dynamic warm-up, which is, you know, your straight leg marches, cradles, high knees, heel kicks, even you can get into skipping patterns, you can get into lunge walks, lunge walk overhead, which will give you a little bit more range of motion, especially through the hip flexors. Karaoke, all the fun stuff that we like to do, and what a lot of kids this age, especially in their club sport or an AAU team, they're starting to do this stuff, but their bodies aren't prepared to even do that. So then we come here. Next, a ton of coordination training, not unlike our 6 to 9 year olds, just a little bit more enhanced. We're trying to get them to the next level with rhythm, reactivity, balance, kinesthetic differentiation, spatial awareness. Any activity that you can get in there that helps with these things, coordination, is huge. Remember, they're going through a time in life where one of the things that's happening, if nothing else, are these big growth spurts where the wiring's getting all messed up, so their body or their brain is saying go, and their body's like, yeah, I used to be able to do that. Now I'm just, you know, I have these bigger feet now, longer legs. You can see, these are the kids, this age group, where the parents will come in and say, you know, he was the fastest kid on the team, or one of the top five, and now he's really struggling, and I don't know why. A lot of times, it's not necessarily systemic strength, which is coming up next, or exact speed and agility drills. it's enhancing their coordination, getting their brain and their bodies to reconnect, if you will. So, segue, I talked about systemic strength. So we look at their entire bodies. Start with body weight. There's always in ways to increase intensity, right? Without an external load, you can use speed, okay? Both fast and slower. Remember, in this age group, we want them to learn how to move better as much as possible. We call this group here exploration. Help them move better. Help them explore how to squat better, how to lunge, how to do push-ups correctly, how to pull up, whether it's horizontal or a vertical pull. So big movements, trained movements, not muscles here, and you can't go wrong. And it's gonna help them get to the next stage, which is, you know, you're 14 plus, where you're introducing bar skills and stuff like that. Now, another big question is, can I introduce external load or even bar skills, dumbbells here? Absolutely. If they're ready for it and it's done in a way that they resonate with and that they like. Because remember, at the end of the day, you also want to build a strong physical culture in these kids. So when they become your high school kids and then even beyond, when they're not with you anymore, they're still extremely active. They move well and they can try just about anything within reason that they want to. If you've heard any of what I'm about in a lot of, you know, the videos that I do, gameplay, for a bunch of different reasons. With this group, for a reward, to reinforce skills that you've worked on. In coordination, if you're working on skipping patterns or arm mechanics within skipping patterns, why not use a game like tag where they have to skip all the time, but they're not actively thinking about, you know, hand cheek to cheek, elbows bent, strong arms, whatever cues you gave them in here, let's let them go a little bit. So it also helps with transference. So there's a reward for hard work the rest of the day. There's transference into sport and life. Biggest one, fun. They have to have fun. We need to find a way as coaches to make all of this as fun as possible. When you do that, their experience is that much better, and guess what? They want to come back, not just for the next session, but for the next week, the next month, the next year. You do this and lay it over all of this. This is where you have a client, the same child, for 5, 6, 7, 8 years. This is where you could have a child in your program from as young as 6 all the way through 18 years old. So when it comes to programming, it's a really good idea to lay this out. Of course, tweak it so that it fits your population, your kids, the kids that you're working with. It's been our experience, whether it's a one-on-one or a large group or a medium-sized group, this always works. So hopefully you can take this back to your businesses and your programs and take it to the next level with 10 to 13-year-old kids. We'll see you soon. Keep being a game changer.